Doris Russell. I teach movement for living well. And this is going to be about a 30-minute yoga practice. The theme of the practice is to really connect into the center, the deep front of your spine. And as a result of that, to feel the width and breadth of the back body. Okay, so I hope you enjoy. You're going to start in Sukhasana. For this practice, you might need a couple of bricks. Okay, so if you have some, have them handy. If not, don't worry. So, in Sukhasana, Sukhasana is a cross-legged posture. You're going to put the right shin in front of the left shin. Your feet go wide apart, your knees are really quite narrow, and your shins are forward, parallel to the front of your mat. Sit up nice and tall, and fold from the deep front groins. Lean into the legs. This is already going to start to open up your hips. And then either remain like that, or move forward and fold. If you can find a way to support the head, better still, so you can really settle into this first posture. Take this moment to slow down. To settle into your body. And to cultivate a slow and steady breath. Deep inhale. And long, smooth exhalation. Now make your way back up. And reach your arms out to the side, nice and wide. Dhanurasana, your right elbow crosses over the left elbow, bind the forearms, lift the elbows. And just close your eyes a moment here. Take two breaths. Inhale. And fully exhale. Deep breath in, feeling the spread across your shoulder blades. And exhale. Unbind your arms, extend your arms out. Reach back onto your fingertips and then onto your hands. So you're tipping back a little. Direct your elbows back and lift up your chest. Two breaths here. In. Really open up the tissue of the front body. And exhale. And again, deep breath in. And exhale. Tip back further into Navasana. Just breathe. Bring the big toe side of your feet to knee. Take one deep breath in here. And as you exhale, start again. Cross the left shin over the right. Knees are narrow, feet are wide. Sit up really tall and fold from the hips. So you keep your spine as long as possible. If you want a bit more opening in the hips, you can always stack the top leg on top of the bottom leg like so. Okay, it's an option. Make sure you don't do that if it compromises your knee in any way. The idea is just to stretch a little deeper into the hips. And so we stay here for a couple of breaths, slow and steady. Do the best that you can to surrender into this position, into this posture, to soften around any resistance. Make your way back up, long, long spine. Extend your arms out, inhale. Now go with us in the left elbow, crosses over right elbow. Couple of breaths here. Inhale, feel the spread across your upper back. And exhale. And again. Unbind the arms, extend them wide, and come back onto the hands. Deep breath in as you expand your chest and exhale. Lifting up the front of the armpits and exhale. Tip back, Navasana, nice and steady, just one breath. And as you exhale, roll over your feet, come into downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Root through the fingertips, lengthen the arms, keep your wrists light, keep your forearms lifted, and keep the shoulders wide, the space around the neck and shoulders broad. Lengthen the sides of your body. Press the tops of your thighs back against the slightly forward motion of your shins. Reach the inner heels back away from your inner toes, your big toes. And then rise up the heels and come down onto your knees. Come onto your fingertips and come into child's. Reaching back through the hips and then walking the hands forward, forward, forward until your forehead comes to the ground. Do keep the wrists and the forearms off the ground as much as you're able to. Just take one breath here. And exhale. And then walk your elbows forward. So your hips are going to go over the knees. Keep the hips over the knees. Engage your center as you walk your elbows further forward. So the head comes to the ground. Make sure that you're holding the abdominal core deep into the front of the spine. So you're not collapsing. Yeah? You're not collapsing through the lower back, but you are trying to explore some opening in the upper spine as much as possible. Just one big breath here. And now as you exhale, release the hands back down to the mat. Come into child's pose. Hands by your knees. And roll up from the deep core, from the base of your spine. Rolling up until the head is the last thing to stack on top of your spine. So this idea of connection through center, width through the back, okay? Come into downward facing dog. Really stretch the inner heels back away from the big toes. Let's raise the heels up and bend the right knee, reaching the left inner heel back away from the left big toe. And then change. And then reach both heels back. So bring your feet together. Take the heels up. Raise your right leg up high, high, high. And then step that foot between your hands as you exhale. Come onto your fingertips. Gently put the back knee down. Back toes long, bring your hands to the front knee. If you need to pad out that knee, please do it. Draw in through your abdominal core, so you ripple up through your spine from the tail to the crown, and take your arms nice and wide. Take a breath in, and as you exhale, bring your forearms to meet, from the elbow to the pinky finger. Inhale, expand across the chest, and exhale, bring the forearms to meet. Again, inhale, and exhale. Now trying to keep the forearms together as you raise them up, 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 until the palms have to turn and you gaze up to your hands. Take a breath, and as you exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Take another breath in. As you exhale, twist around to the right side, bring your left elbow across the right knee, and press the right hand into the left hand so you can twist the spine around the right. So either remain just like that, or if you want to, you can tuck the back toes. And from your center, extend the back leg out. Take a deep breath in here. And as you exhale, bring your hands down and step into downward facing dog. From down dog, raise the heels and ripple through the spine into plank. Feel the width of your back here and the connection through your center. As you exhale, chaturanga. Then lower the whole body down. Inhale, cobra. Roll the shoulder heads back, open up the heart. Big breaths. Tuck your toes. Exhale, downward facing dog. Bring your feet together. Raise the heels, left leg high. Inhale.
Step your left foot through between your hands. Exhale, come onto your fingertips. Breathe in, and as you exhale, knee comes down, toes go long. Hands to the front knee, and draw in through the pit of the belly, the deep front of your spine as you ripple up to vertical. Arms wide on the inhale, bring your forearms to meet on the exhale. Inhale, open wide, exhale, and together, one more time. Inhale, and exhale. Keep your forearms together and raise them up, 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 up. Take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Take another one. As you exhale, rotate to the left side this time. Hook your right elbow across and press the left palm into the right palm so you draw into your belly away from your left thigh into rotation. You can tuck the back toes there if you would like to and extend the back leg. Make sure you're doing that from the center. Take a deep breath. And as you exhale, hands down. Downward facing. Urdhva. Ripple into plank as you inhale. Chaturanga as you exhale. Cobra, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Root through the fingertips. Keep the wrists light, the forearms buoyant, lifted, the shoulders wide, side body long, long, long. Press the tops of your thighs back. Reach the inner heels back away from the big toes. Raise the heels up high. Take the right leg up high and stack right hip over left hip. Bending your right knee. We're going to flip the dog. This is an option. So either stay here where you are, or if you're going to flip your dog, you keep going, that right hand gets light and the foot's going to come to the ground. Wild thing. Inhale, lift your hips up. And as you exhale, re-flip your dog around and bring that right foot through between your hands all the way to the front. Ground the back foot, ready for warrior two, and come up. Take a moment to find warrior two through the legs, through the hips, and extend the arms out. Garudasana, right elbow over left. Lift the elbows, take a breath. And as you exhale, you're going to turn the torso and the forearms to your left, away from the right knee. Keeping the right knee directly over the ankle. And then release your arms out, broad from your chest. Look to the right hand, Virabhadrasana two. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, let your left arm just swing back and catch your right hip. You're going to pull that right hip back, back, back. This takes you into triangle pose, Trikonasana. Extending both sides of the back nice and long. Rotate your left shoulder over your right shoulder. And releasing that left arm up. So again here, get this sense of a connected center and a really broad, broad back. Take a breath. Exhale. Bring your left hand down. You're going to step into half moon. So you might want a brick for this one. You step forward. Brick will be forward two paces and a little bit out to the right side. Urdhva Dhanurasana, half moon. So the back leg parallels the floor. Rotate the left hip over the right. Rotate your shoulders and extend the arm up. Take a deep breath in here. Again, with this sense of connection through center and width in the back of your body. And then bring your left hand down. So you could use the brick for your hands here if you want. And square your hips. Warrior one. Bend the right knee. Bring the back foot down. Bring your forearms to meet. And ripple up through your spine into warrior one. As your forearms lift up, your palms eventually meet, and you gaze up. Take a breath in here. Bring your gaze forward, open your arms, exhale. Inhale, rotate your arms internally, and bring your hands behind you, fingertips meet, into reverse prayer. Open up the collarbones. Take a breath in, root through your right leg and stretch it, and go back with your hands. Inhale. As you exhale, fold forward from your hips. We're coming into Vajradhanasana. Long on spine. Release the hands either to the ground or use your bricks. Take a breath in. Square your hips, pull the right hip back, left hip forward, and as you exhale, fold over your right leg. Deep breath in. And as you exhale, bend your right knee, step forward, Utkatasana, feet together. Forearms meet, and up you come, rippling up through your spine into chair pose. Deep breath in here. As you exhale, root through the feet, stand tall, and bring your hands to your heart. Take a moment. Regulate breathing. Surya Namaskar A, Sun Salutation A. Take a nice deep breath in. As you exhale, heel down. Inhale, rising. Exhale, fold forward, touch the ground. Gaze into your navel. Inhale, out through the crown of the head, long spine. Exhale, hands flat, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Second side to that whole sequence. So take your left leg up high now. Stack your left hip over your right hip. Bending the knee. As that leg travels behind you, if you're going to flip your dog, that left hand gets lighter. And you land down. Exhale, wild thing. Inhale. And then exhale, reflip your dog and bring that left foot through. Warrior two. Taking some time just to organize the pelvis and the legs. Extending the arms out. So Garudasana, left over right this time. Feel how the left knee stays over the ankle. Take a breath, and as you exhale, turn your torso away from that. Turning to the right wants to keep your left knee open. And then release the arms out, inhale broad from your chest, gaze over the left hand. Let your right hand come back, catch the hip, and pull it back into triangle pose, Uddita Trikonasana. Remember to keep the rooting through your left foot, especially the front of the foot, so that the heel can be light. Rotate right shoulder over left shoulder, and extend your right arm. Rooting through the feet and legs, steady through the legs, connected into your core and broad across your back. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, right hand comes to the hip, and you're going to shift into half moon. Step the back foot in, or the front foot back, and come in. So, back leg parallel to the floor, stacking right hip over left hip, extending the right arm up. Urdhva dhanurasana. Take a breath in here, and as you exhale, your right hand comes down. Square the hips, so use bricks under your hands, or any prop you might have handy, or hands to the ground. Square the hips here. Warrior one, right foot down, Bring your forearms together, ripple up through your spine, and extend the arms up. Take a deep breath in here. And as you exhale, open the arms out wide, take another breath, rotate the palms, and come into reverse prayer. Inhale, rooting through the left foot, that stretches you back, you go over the hands, big breath. And as you exhale, fold forward from the hips. Slide the hands to your bricks or to the ground. Square the hips, pull the left hip back, right hip forward, take a breath. And as you exhale, urdhva dhanurasana, forward fold. Deep inhale, and long, smooth exhale. Bend your front leg, step forward, chair pose, utkatasana, inhale. Sitting deeply through the seat, long spine, take a breath in. And as you exhale, stand tall, hands at your heart. Take a deep breath. Sudha Namaskar A, as you exhale, yield. Inhale, rise. Exhale, fold forward, touch the ground. Inhale, out through the crown. Long, long spine, Urdhva Dhanurasana. As you exhale, hands come down, Chaturanga. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha, upward facing dog. Really open the front of the hips and the spine. And as you exhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Couple of deep breaths here. Bend the knees, look forward, spring to the front of your mat. And bring yourself up to stand. Okay, so now, a bit of fun. We're going to kick up to handstand and a little bit of arm balancing. So find a wall space. Bring your hands to about a shin's distance from your wall. Okay, more or less. That's where your hands go. And when you're ready, kick up. Bend the knees and put the feet against the wall. Like so. And then you can try balancing, stretch one leg at a time. And then come down, when you come down, relax the wrists. Okay, alternatively, if you don't want to kick up to handstand, you can come into downward facing dog with your heels up against the wall. And then you can take one foot up to the wall at a time, about hip height. And then stretch your legs so your pelvis comes over the shoulders. You can bring your feet together here. And if you're feeling steady, you can take one leg up into handstand. Couple of breaths. And then you can come down and rest. Okay? And then you can do the other side, obviously. So have a few attempts if you like. Press pause. Have a little play around with that. And then when you're ready, come back to the mat. Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Raise the heels up high, come down onto your knees, sit back in child's, and just sweep your arms back by your legs so you can fully relax the shoulders, the arms, and the wrists. Okay,
to vertical,
and turn around line to back, bridging. So we're going to do a couple of bridges.
Arms at your side, feet flat on the ground. Pick your pelvis up, so lift up, root through the big toe side of your feet. Tuck your shoulder blades underneath you. Interlace your hands, lifting up your sternum. And remain here for two breaths. Inhale. And exhale. And again. And exhale. And then bring your arms down and slowly sequence down.
So you can repeat what you've just done one more time. Or if you'd like to go into full wheel or into dhanurasana, you're also ready for that.
Hands underneath your shoulders. Lift your pelvis up first. And then slide to the top of the head.
Root evenly through your feet and through your hands. And then up you go. Use your legs. And lift up. Two deep breaths here. In and out. Inhale and exhale. Bring the top of your head to the ground.
Lengthen the back of the neck and come down. Okay, so keeping the feet on the ground, but quite close to your seat, and as wide as your mat, just let your knees drop in towards one another, and relax. And then bring your arms into a cactus shape.
Let your legs drop over to the right. And your head to the left.
Just a nice little twist, easing out the back. Option to put the right ankle on top of the left knee there, if you want a bit more leverage. Just take a breath in. And as you exhale, unhook and come back to your center, go over to the other side.
Hook the foot, come back to the center,
hug the knees into your chest.
Okay, so roll yourself up, come into downward facing dog again. From Adho Mukha Svanasana, we're going to go into pigeon. Raise the heels, take the right leg high, bring the right knee forward into pigeon. Your time as you adjust into the posture. If you feel any discomfort at all through the knee, do prop yourself up, prop up the right hip with a brick. Make your way down and support the head.
Two breaths here. Inhale. And exhale. And again. Make your way up onto your hands.
An option to take the back foot if you want to, add a thigh stretch here. Otherwise, just stay as you are. Gently release that foot and tip to the right side. Let your left leg come around to the front. And we revisit Sukhasana. So left leg folded in front of right leg. And just very briefly, tipping forward again. Just noticing the effects of your practice. Hopefully this second time round, Sukhasana feels easier than when you just started the practice. Tip back onto the hands, revisit Navasana very brief. And then roll over your feet, other Mukha Svanasana. Left leg goes high, inhale, pigeon on the left. Bring the left knee forward. Gently slide the back leg out. Remember that that leg has to be in line with the hip. The big toe reaching back away from the inner heel. And when you feel you have your posture, you can come down and support your head or rest onto your hands. A couple of breaths here. Deep inhale. And exhale. And again, deep inhalation. And exhale. So coming back up. So you can take the back foot if you like into the hand, or just stay upright like this, just a little bit. And then you can release that foot if you took it. Tip to the left. Bring your right leg from behind you around. It crosses in front of the left. You're back into Sukhasana. Very, very brief. Tipping forward. Last breath here. And then make your way back. Great. Okay, Shavasana. So just lie yourself out onto your mat. Get comfortable, cover yourself. I do recommend covering your eyes to stop the rapid eye movement. So make sure you're warm, comfortable, relaxed. And maybe set yourself a little alarm. 5 minutes would be great, so that you can really rest. It's such an important part of the practice, okay? So a few minutes in Shavasana. Namaste, thanks for joining me.